All right, just want to kind of run through how to tie a pretty simplified Muddler Minnow. Basically, this what we're using is a Tiemco 270R hook, just some flat diamond braid in silver, some Arizona semi-seal dubbing, kind of in their red. It's got a nice little flash in there, and then just some natural elk hair, deer hair, you know, whatever you kind of prefer. And you can do it in different colors, but this, again, like I said, is just the natural. So let's get to it. Start, I already pinched my barb down here. Start our thread up at the midway point. On the hook, attach it. Trim off the tag end. Now we're gonna go and attach our flat diamond braid. Let's come around, catch it there. Pull the end here so it's a couple eye lengths back from the eye. Take our thread, wind it back. I like to go just past the point, kind of between where the barb would be and the point of the hook. Right in there. Bring this back up. Gonna trap those guys down so they don't flare out all over. Too bad. So now we go and wrap this forward. Again, just want to make sure each wrap is just on top of the last, slightly, just so you overlap so there's no gaps in there. Putting a decent amount of pressure, not using all my strength, but just enough here. Bring it up probably about quarter inch back from the eye. We'll tie that off. Again, this guy just real easy, three materials, and you're out fishing. We'll trim that off. Next step is to add our dubbing. We're basically gonna make a dubbing ball in a dubbing loop, which is nice. It allows you to kind of pick out the materials in the dubbing and really kind of make it flare out so it's visible. There, so I'm attaching my dubbing twirler. Loop form. I'm gonna load that up. I'll go ahead and spin it. There we go. Now we're gonna wrap it. Now I want to leave room for my deer hair head up there, so I don't want to go too close to the eye. I'll just kind of couple wraps forward, couple wraps back, kind of going on top of itself. And that's about enough, so I'm going to tie that off like so. Trim that. What I'm going to do with my thread is make sure that is kind of lashed down pretty well there. Bring that back. And then if the dubbing ball that you make is kind of a little tight, I like to have it, all the fibers kind of really out wild and kind of buggy looking. So you can take your dubbing brush or even your bodkin, kind of pick some of that stuff out to get how you like. Really right there is good enough for me. So last step is to add our deer hair. I'm going to cut a clump off here, the hide. And for this fly, about that much is what I like. I'm going to do it all in one clump here. You could stack this and pick out the under fur. But again, you know, it's just kind of a down and dirty fly for me. You know, if you look at the ends here, they're ending at different points. I'm totally fine with that. If you wanted to, you could put it in a stack or clean it out. But so I'm going to have the ends so they're going not quite to the point. It's about where I want it. Pinch here. And you may have seen this trick before. If not, it's a nice one. We're going to trim the deer hair before we spin it so we don't have to go back in and take our time to trim it once it's spun. So I'm going to take it and clip it like so. Now it's time to spin. So take one wrap real soft, The second wrap here, once we do that, we're going to kind of let go and let it spin, kind of continue wrapping. And there's that, flares out nice. What I'm going to do is, got to find that eye of the hook in there so we can kind of build up a small head and then whip finish. So we kind of got that. There it is, take my thread, build up a small head, just kind of push some of those, the trimmed ends back, like so. Last step is the whip finish. So before you kind of whip, just train or pinch all those trimmed ends of the deer hair back so you don't lash any of those guys down inadvertently. There's our whip. Trim the thread. And you're ready to rock. Again, this fly is great for steelhead, trout, rivers, lakes, you name it, lots of applications, bass. Just get out, tie them, fish them. Thanks a lot, guys.